In part 3 of our lesson on sum and difference identities for cosine, we will work through some applications of the sum and difference identities. In this example, we're given that sine of s is equal to 12 over 13 with s in quadrant 2, and cosine of t is 3/5 with t in quadrant 4. We have to find the cosine of s plus t and the cosine of s minus t. Let's take these angles one at a time. We're told that angle s lives in quadrant 2, so let's get a picture of that going. We know that the sine of s is equal to 12 thirteenths. So we can sketch that in our picture. If this is s, we know that sine of s is going to be the y value divided by r. One of the things you have to be very, very careful about is the positive and negative signs. Notice that because we're in quadrant 2, we know the x value is going to be negative. I would suggest you put it in your picture as soon as you make that realization so you don't forget to do it. Now, when we solve for x, we're going to be using the Pythagorean theorem here. So we know x is going to be negative square root of the hypotenuse squared minus the other leg squared. So that's going to be negative square root 169 minus 144, which is negative radical 25, which is negative 5. So we can label that x is negative 5 in our picture. Now let's turn our attention to angle T. We're told that angle T is in quadrant 4. So we can get its picture going here. We know that the cosine of T is 3/5, so that tells us that the x value is 3. R has to be 5. And because we are in quadrant 4, we know that our y value is going to have to be negative. So y is going to be negative radical. Remember, once again here, y is a leg, so we're going to take the hypotenuse, which is 5, and square it, minus the other leg, which is 3, squared. We get negative square root of 25 minus 9, which is negative radical 16, which is negative 4. Now, once you've done enough right triangles, you may just notice that this is what we call a Pythagorean triple, a 3-4-5 triangle, and you're welcome to use that and go right to knowing that this leg was going to be 4. And of course, we need to label in the picture angle T. Now we know about angle S. We know all of its sides. Now we know about angle T. And we can use the identities we just learned to find cosine of S plus T and cosine of S minus T. Cosine of S plus T. Well, let's write out the identity. We know it's going to be the cosine of the first angle, so that's s, times the cosine of the second angle, t, minus sine of the first angle, s, times sine of the second angle, t. Now we can start to fill in those four different values. cosine of s. We go right to the picture of s here. We know cosine is going to be x over r, so that's going to be negative 5 over 13. Cosine of t, we come over here to the picture of t and do x over r, so we get 3/5 minus sine of s is going to be the y value over r, so that's going to be 12 over 13, and sine of t will be the y value over r, negative 4/5. When you go to multiply out this first product, normally you would be looking to cancel these 5s, but I don't suggest you do that, and here's why. You can see your denominator here would be 13 times 5, which is exactly the same as the denominator over here. You're going to want to keep your common denominator. Don't cancel it out. So here we have a common denominator of 65 already, right? 13 times 5. From this first product, we're getting negative 5 times 3 is negative 15. From this second product, we're getting 12 times negative 4 is negative 48, but we have that minus sign here, so it becomes plus 48. Negative 15 plus 48 is 33, and the denominator is 65. So there's the cosine of s plus t. Next, we have to do the cosine of s minus t. So first, let's just write out the identity. We know it would be cosine of s, which is the first angle, times cosine of t, the second angle, plus sine of the first angle, s, sine of the second angle, t. And now we're ready to fill in these values. The cosine of s is equal to x over r, so that's going to be negative 5 over 13. Cosine of t is x over r, so 3/5, plus the sine of s, which is the y value over the r value, 12 over 13, times the sine of t, which is negative 4 over 5, Once again, our denominators are both 65, so we're going to just keep that denominator. From the first product, we have negative 5 times 3 is negative 15. From the second product, we have 12 times negative 4, which is negative 48. We're adding those, so this becomes minus 48. And then negative 15 minus 48 is equal to negative 63, and our denominator is 65. So here is the cosine of s minus t. In this example, we are given that the tangent of s is equal to 3/4, that s is between pi and 3 pi over 2. Next, we're told that the sine of t is 15 over 17, and that t is between pi over 2 and pi. And we have to find the cosine of s minus t and the cosine of s plus t. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. Let's begin with angle S, and if S has to be between pi and 3 pi over 2, we know pi is here, 3 pi over 2 is here, so that means S is a quadrant 2 angle. Furthermore, we know that the tangent of S is equal to 3 over 4. Now, this is where you have to be really careful. Because we are in quadrant 3, we know that the x value is going to have to be negative and the y value is going to have to be negative. I really strongly suggest you put those negative signs in right away. It would be easy to forget to do that because the tangent is positive since it's a negative over a negative. So even though we know this is y over x, the y value is not 3, the y value is negative 3, and the x value is negative 4. Negative 3 over negative 4 becomes positive 3/4, but you have to make sure you're paying careful attention to the signs of your x and y values based on the quadrant. Now we can find r, because we know that r is going to be the square root of negative 3 squared plus negative 4 squared. We know this will be the square root of 9 plus 16, which is radical 25, which is 5. And again, you may have noticed this is a 3, 4, 5 right triangle. Next, we can turn our attention to angle T, and we know that T has to be between pi over 2 and pi, which means that angle T is in quadrant 2. We are given that the sine of angle T is 15 over 17, so we know the y value will be 15, r will be 17, and the x value is going to have to be negative because we are in quadrant 2. X is going to equal negative square root of the hypotenuse, 17 squared, minus the other leg, 15 squared, or you can think of it as r squared minus y squared. We get the opposite of 289 minus 225, which is the opposite of 64, which is negative 8. So our x value is negative 8. We are ready now to find cosine of s minus t and cosine of s plus t. You always want to start by writing down the identity. So here we're going to find cosine of s minus t, and we know that identity is cosine of s cosine of t plus sine of s times sine of t. Then all we have to do is fill in the values. We know that cosine of s is going to be the x value, which is negative 4, divided by r, which is 5. Cosine of t is going to be its x value, which is negative 8, divided by r, which is 17. plus, we have to find the sine of s. We come over to the picture of s and get the y value, negative 3, divided by r, which is 5. And then we get sine of t, which is its y value, 15, over its r value, 17. As you've seen a number of times now, we have a common denominator already, and that denominator is 5 times 17, which is 85. In this first product, we're going to be multiplying negative 4 times negative 8 to get positive 32. In the second product, we're going to have negative 3 times 15. We're adding those, so that means it's going to be minus 45. When we simplify that, we're going to get negative 13 over 85. Now we're ready to find cosine of s plus t. So we write the identity down. We know it's cosine of the first, s, cosine of the second, t, minus sine of the first, s, sine of the second, t. And we begin to fill in the values. Cosine of s is x over r, so we're going to get negative 4/5. Cosine of t is its x value over r, so negative 8 over 17. The sine of s is going to be y over r, so negative 3/5. And the sine of t is y over r, so 15 over 17. Our common denominator is 85, which is 5 times 17 in both fractions, so we can go ahead and write that denominator in. In this first product, we have negative 4 times negative 8 is positive 32. In the second product, we have a minus 3 times 15, which is negative 45, but we're subtracting that. So this turns into plus 45. And we see that our result is going to be 32 plus 45, which is 77 over 85.